Good afternoon, Mind Readers. Today, we are playing Episode Arden, Arden's Side Story. And perhaps we'll finish Final Fantasy XV with Gladio's Side Story. But this will probably not be the end of Final Fantasy XV due to that there's a lot of roaming quests in this game. So, having turned Empire to shambles and shoveled, shrouded the world in darkness, Arden, healer of those who ail, now it sits atop the Lucian throne, denied him by the crystal some 2 millennia ago. Millennia ago? Yeesh. Also, if you hear anything in the background, that's my studio neighbors making noise. M.E.766.
Long ago, there lived a man, blessed by the gods and revered by the people as their savior. His name was Arden Lucis Kyla, and he was to have served as the first king of Lucis.
Oh, so the work, that's Arden. Arden Lucis Callum. They parade.
and that must be the king's castle.
Delayed reaction, man. Whoa. Final Fantasy 15, episode arting. The year is FE 734. Spirits are high in the Crown City as all of Insomnia prepares to celebrate Founder's Day, yet the citizens of Lucian capital are in a rude awakening. Arden has returned to interrupt their peaceful revere and wreak havoc upon his former home, first reflecting on the events that brought him here. Oh, so we're going to see his path before this all happened. Okay. Chapter 1, Darkness Awakens. With the boy. Even the ancestor of Luna Freya, Floray, the one in the main game. Huh. Uh-oh. ME.721. Baptistia.
Take him away.
We killed this guy last time and he was embodied with a giant worm. In the Prompto side story.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, another looky around. So, Mephlehem soldiers, Empire. Why are you pointing your gun back there, huh?
Status report. Everything is fine here.
Roger that. We'll transport the subject to your location.
And we'll have a medical team ready as well.
What's the situation over there?
Nothing to report. We're just...
So are these your humans? Robot! Defense in here. We passed out already. Ouch. And eminent magic tech, logical expert, steals away to the... Can I read that? Because of the background. Unhabitable, maybe? Isle of Anglegard, and abscond with Lucius' darkest secret, Adagium. He escorts our subject back to one of the Empire's magic tech research facilities for further study. So we're a lab rat.
Great.
Oh my god, he killed her!
You don't want your food getting cold, do you? Are you enjoying your stay? You've been asleep for years, learning to appreciate the waking world would take time.
Perhaps I can help enlighten you while we dine.
Ask about the food. Okay.
What is this meat cloned in this facility? We cultivated somatic cells, used them as donors to fuse the nucleus transplant cells to the recipient oocytes, and then we...
Enough! I have no ear for the ramblings of a lunatic. What is it you want from me anyhow? What about me interesting yourself?
You said it yourself, didn't you? You were chosen by the gods. And frankly, with powers like yours, I'd say you're nearly a god in your own right. We need those powers that you possess. With your strength on our side, we could finally put an end to the gruesome war with Eusis. You too must desire the fall of the kingdom that cast you into exile. Descendants live on to this day. Surely you must bear them some feelings of ill will.
My feelings are not your concern.
Come along.
Thank you.
existed till I saw you with my own eyes. With your help, my research is proceeding smoothly. You have my thanks.
Demons were first officially recognized as a new species roughly 200 years ago. According to ancient texts, however, humans have suffered from a parasitic plague wrought by the demons for upwards of 2 millennia. Demonification is caused by a mutant strand of plasmodium that takes root in living creatures and changes their cellular structures. Infected creatures begin to disperse miasmal particles, the spread of which is known as the Star Scourge. This logo is a replica made from plaster poured into a demon-shaped cavity discovered deep underground. Demons summon when their vital functions cease, so this particular specimen must have vaporized after the mud around it had already solidified. Scientists believe this subject burrowed into the earth in order to shield itself from the light of the sun.
Something most interesting on the rock of Ravator. If my experiment on this specimen succeeds, it might provide the information you've been looking for. This way.
Turn him into a
It's certainly an enticing offer, isn't it? Just think, you could exact sweet revenge through divine retribution.
Have you
thought of
that?
I don't,
but I know you have no other options.
Well, shall we? Come see the fruits of my magitech research. This way. The ancient civilization of Solheim, forefathers of our magic technology, once flourished on this land. Had they not incurred the wrath of the gods, they may have remained prosperous to this day.
And you wish to restore them to greatness?
To surpass them, which is why I need you to lend me your strength. But I'm certain magic technology and demons are the keys to unlocking the door to a new future.
Die trying.
Whoa, he's actually doing it!
Longer shall I seek your guidance.
insane.
The Empire's demonic experiments bore fruit before long, precipitating the production of the Magitek infantry. As recognition for his contribution to this research, Arden Azulia was inaugurated as Imperial Chancellor. Thanks to its newfound firepower, Niflheim managed to break the stalemate that shackled the nation for more than 100 years, and, in turn, forced Lucis to scale back its magical barrier. The untimely passing of King Mors ushered in the era of a new monarch, and the young Regis Lucis Kylo succeeded the throne. Meanwhile, Arden began to spread the Star Scourge throughout the world, stealing people's memories and learning as much about the kingdom as he could. In time, those memories began to merge with his own, gradually transforming him into a wicked echo of his former self. And now, at long last, the time for his revenge has come.
Yes, safe progress. Betrayed by his brother and benefit of his beloved, Arden is burdened with the blessing of eternal life. His feelings of eternity, the enemy toward the lion Lucis, grow greater with each passing day as darkness continues to consume his body and soul. Oh God, I'm sick. Oh, this can't believe it's alright. Almost over, March is also almost over, main majors. Soon it's gonna be April. Already the fourth month of 2022. Chapter 3, Fiery Vengeance. Regis Lucis Kylo. That was not just his dad.
Thank you.
also adjusted the view of the thing.
I've marked the location of all the devices they're using to amplify the war. They seem to be positioned on rooftops around the city. Find them and destroy them.
With pleasure. I'll be sure to keep you abreast of my progress. No rest for the wicked.
That's not good. Waiting for me that during a fight!
One of the wall amplifiers has been destroyed.
Ow. That's a moneymaker.
Oh.
system buildings in the house that saw this.
What's the situation? Unfavorable. The target has been destroyed. All the wall of the house. Who is he? We can't identify him.
Power up. And there we go. Now which way is the king? Oh, that way.
Time to head back down.
Jeez, they keep on coming.
Eat it, eat fire.
Something wrong, officer?
Ah, you must be His Majesty.
I'm pleased to make your acquaintance.
Why are you here?
Why, for you.
The Royal Arms? Who are you?
You ought to know, being a man of royal blood yourself.
Adagium.
In the flesh. He has to bring the bloodline of Lucis to a...
Give me Adagio. On my honor as a king, I will fight for you.
What kind of power is that? Laying out the swords or some kind of jewel move? Where'd you go?
Of course I'll see you there.
Now we have flying swords around him. Where is this? Yeah, take this. Somnus? That's Somnus? That's a big boy! Yeah, we know this is Somnus.
And who was born to this gap? Who could have exiled him?
What the? Whoa! That's cool. But also not good!
What I did to you was unforgivable, but I did it for the future of our kingdom, of our people.
A small sacrifice for the good of society. How noble.
Our line has done everything in our power to protect our people, just as the gods bade. I was merely fulfilling my calling.
And here I thought I was the blessed one, but it was you all along.
I dare not ask your forgiveness. I do ask. test your understanding.
What?
What? You took everything, and you ask my understanding? I pray your soul find repose, brother.
Wow. Mother of Pearl. Oh, it's Muhammad from the main story, Giant Torch. Oh, whoa. It's Arden! I surrender. I'm not fighting under God. Another one, at least not Bahamut.
Though I am to serve the shadows and surrender to the scion of a usurper, so long as it brings the royal bloodline to an end, so long as I get my revenge,
Thank you.
to hell with them all.
We already saw that, and Arden loses. We kicked his butt. Centuries of suffering, Arden prepares to finally free himself from the shackles of cruel fate by killing the king of... Basically, it's describing how it ended. But that... is Arden's side story. I'll see you later, my invaders.